Good evening and welcome. Let's take a look at the top story that we are following for you. Nepal's Foreign Minister, Pradeep Kumar Gyawali, met his Indian counterpart, Dr. S. Jaishankar, today. Now, this is the first face-to-face meeting since the border row led to a slide in ties. Nepal government has approved the use of AstraZeneca Covishield vaccine, which is manufactured in India. Now, Kathmandu is keen to purchase around 12 million doses of the COVID-19 vaccines from India. Both sides also discussed several areas of cooperation, including the areas of connectivity, economy and trade, power and political and security issues. Now, this is the first high-level visit from Kathmandu in over a year. Nepal's foreign minister said that Nepal has always ensured that its soil was never misused for illegitimate interests of any neighboring country.
Please allow me to refrain, make any comments to other countries in foreign land. We have not that type of practice. But I can just say that Nepal has always maintained a good relationship with our both neighbors.
We never compare our relations with our friends. We have ensured that our soil will not be misused to the legitimate interest of any neighboring countries. And we look our location as an opportunity, because being located between the two largest market of the globe speaks a volume. It provides us to be benefited by the prosperous economic growth of our neighboring countries. So that's why we are strengthening our relation with our neighboring countries, but we never compare our relations.
We're being joined by our diplomatic correspondent, Sidhant Sibal, for more on this. Good evening to you, Sidhant. Now, this is the first face-to-face meeting between Nepal's foreign minister and India's Dr. S. Jaishankar since the border row, and several areas of cooperation, including areas of economy, trade, power, political and security issues. What are some of the big takeaways from this meeting?
Well, Alison, today was one of the most significant days when it comes to India-Nepal conversation in perhaps more than a year, and coming, of course, in the backdrop of the border row. But the fact that a high-level visit has taken from Kathmandu to New Delhi for, of course, the Joint Commission meeting showcases that how, amidst even the tense ties because of the border row, both sides are willing to reach out. In fact, three important officials from India had visited to Nepal last year, towards the end of the last year. One, of course, was the intelligence chief, the army chief, and the foreign secretary. But talking about today's conversation, which took place between the two foreign ministers, this was a conversation which is expected to be a frank conversation on how the relationship stands and what is the future of the relationship. We know a release has been issued by the Indian government, by the Ministry of External Affairs, where the key focus by New Delhi was on the COVID cooperation between the two countries. Remember, New Delhi has sent out a number of medicines to Nepal amidst the crisis, and also on the development projects, something that New Delhi is working a lot in Nepal in terms of hydropower projects, in terms of connectivity project, how to connect with Kathmandu itself. So these were the key focus areas. But what stood out was the speech made by the foreign minister here in Delhi, a public speech made by the foreign minister, in which he talked about not only the areas of cooperation, but also talked about contentious issues. The two contentious issues he mentioned was a frank conversation he wanted with New Delhi on the border issue, and of course the trade deficit, which he said is increasing with New Delhi, and on that also they would like to have some kind of relaxation from India. But largely in response to a Vyon question, a direct question on China, the only question he took on China, on how the Chinese influence has been growing, he responded by saying that Nepal sees both New Delhi and Beijing as partners in their growth, and they consider their position, geographic position, in a sense, an opportunity for the country to grow, given the fact that both India and China are two large economies growing at a good rate. That, of course, can benefit Nepal. But, of course, here in New Delhi, there are concerns of a growing influence of China, not only in Kathmandu, but across the South Asian region. But largely, it looks like both sides are keen to bring the relationship on track, to make sure that if there are contentious issues, if there are differences, they can be sorted out, but also both sides can work on issues of convergences between the two countries. So we do expect more positive development in this relationship. But of course, the big focus is on the political crisis in Nepal. We know that Nepal will be heading to elections in few months' time, and the outcome is something that everyone will be keen to know.
Right. And Sudan, one more thing to focus on. Nepal hoping to secure the Indian-made coronavirus vaccine. They're hoping to procure around 12 million doses of Covishield. What is the latest we have on that?
Well, that is something that the Nepali side has requested from the Indian side, and the Indian side will be keen to fulfill that requirement, because that, of course, has been India's priority. We know last year the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the United Nations General Assembly speech highlighted that India's vaccine is just not for India but for the entire humanity. We know that requests have been coming across the region. In fact, the Myanmar leader Aung San Suu Kyi, during her New Year's address, talked about how they have already signed a contract with India. Bangladesh is also working on that, and we know there are a number of high-level visits from India, whether it's foreign secretary's visit to Bangladesh, Myanmar, Nepal, or Maldives, or whether it is foreign ministers visit, external affairs minister to Sri Lanka. The key focus was on the COVID vaccine, and amidst the COVID pandemic, India was able to reaffirm its position as the pharma capital of the world, sending HCQ and paracetamol to almost 150 countries. In fact, even as we speak, we know that a plane is expected to leave Brazil to India to get vaccines as well. This is being confirmed by the Brazilian Foreign Ministry. So largely, we know that India is going to fulfill that, but how much is something that will be also a key focus area. But as of now, in just last 1 hour, the big news which has come from Kathmandu is that their regulatory authorities have given approval for Covishield vaccine being produced here in India.
Right, Sudan, thank you very much for bringing us all the latest on that meeting.
Co-presented by Škoda. Simply clever.
We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.